So Pitch Perfect, congratulations for the first movie phenomena.
Oh, thank you.
You get to make a second one.
Yeah.
Everybody's so excited.
So nice.
So I know that the Green Bay Packers cameo in this film, yeah. I know you to be a huge Chicago sports fan, you're a huge Bears fan.
Yes.
I find it hard to believe that the Packers, you would write a role in your film for Green Bay Packers.
I almost didn't.
Yeah, what
I was
happened?
Like, I can't write for the Green Bay Packers. Well, a lot of people know the Green Bay Packers loved the first movie, and they came to the producers, and they were like, if you put us in the sequel, we will rehearse, we will sing, we will, you know, we're athletes, we're gonna do this, we're gonna take it serious. And so the producers would come to me and they're like, I'm pretty sure the Green Bay Packers are gonna be in the movie. And I would be, at these script meetings, I was like, guys, what are we doing? Like, really? I think we should like just keep it with the Bellas and the Trebles and everything. And so then when they were finally definitely gonna do it, it was kind of fun to write the bits. They're so funny in the movie. They're just,
and we
sing.
Have it. You did, yeah. But you made it clear. You took a photo with them at this is the after
the,
party.
This is the after party at the premiere.
And you made it clear how you feel about Packers. Give them a big thumbs down there.
I should also say that at the premiere, I saw them because I wasn't on set when they shot it. And when I saw them, they knew that the writer of the movie was a big Bears fan. And there was like a lot of like flipping me off through emails and stuff. And so when I saw them, I just like ran right to them.
Yeah.
Like my head was gonna explode. And I was like, I'm the writer. And they're so big that I felt like I had to shout up for them to hear me. And then with no like thanks for being in the movie or anything, I just screamed at them, I'm a Bears fan! And no Green Bay Packer wants to hear that you're a Bears fan. So I was able to make up for it at the after party.
And when did it first sort of set into you that there might be a sequel for a movie like this? Like, when did you realize how popular it was gonna be?
Yeah, I think it was like not until like when the DVD came out right for the holidays and I went home and I was shopping at Target. Plug for Target. there was all these racks of the Pitch Perfect DVDs, and I was just shocked that people still buy DVDs, but it was beyond that. They were all sold out, and I was like, oh, this is, you know, not only iTunes and when the movie's on cable, but I was like, this is something, that these are all sold out. They're all being given as gifts. And there was this one guy, you know, I felt like there's a lot of closeted adult straight males who like the movie who don't want to admit they like the movie.
So the closeted part is their Pitch Perfect fans.
Not the other thing. It's all that they're Pitch Perfect fans. And there, I was at my birthday party. I throw this really wild and crazy birthday party with two other comedy writers. It's so sexy. Yeah. And there's like all like sorts of people there. And a lot that I don't even know. And this one guy, all I remember is that he was like not wearing an undershirt and he just had like a vest on and a fedora.
Cool cat.
Yeah. And he pulls me in real tight and he was like, so I'm trying to get laid, right? And also I was 8.5 months pregnant. So I was like, who is this guy like talking to me like this? And he goes, and this girl, she's like, before we do this, I want to watch a movie. I'm like, okay, I know where this is going. And he's like, freaking Pitch Perfect. I had to sit there and watch it. And then I'm like, okay, thanks. He pulls me real close and he goes, I effing loved it.
It's the foreplay of musicals.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for being here. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Can't wait.
Thank you,
Brandon. Hey, Brandon, everybody.